chance to share my experience about Goa and this place to this webinar series. And welcome to everybody to second round webinar series, which is organized by the Vishwavadi Library Network. Today, my topic is. Today, my topic is this space. Last month, we have shared our experience about Goa. And this month we are going to organize our experience about this place. This place is not a single topic. It has many wings to discuss, to proper customization and introduce and application of this place in the organization. Like installation process, customization process, harvesting of metadata, maintenance of repositories, and also copyright act for display the documents. There are many ways to discuss about the display. So within a 1 hour, it is not possible to discuss all the topics separately. So today we have tried to share our experience about installation process of this place and limited customization. How can we customize the display and run this display in our organization? Nowadays, we have lockdown period. We have listened that the government has decided the next 2 or 3 years, no new project will be taken by the government. So, we have no extra fund to take any new project. So, we have a limited fund and infrastructure to do this project within a limited capacities to use the open source software. Last month we have discussed about the two open source software, one is Ubuntu and Goa. Today also we have tried to explain or experience our opinion about the two open source software, Ubuntu and Dispace. Along with Dispace, there are so many another open source software like Tomcat, Postgres, NVL, and etc. So mainly two open source software is important. That is Ubuntu and Dispace. There is a two process. One is traditional process. You have to install the Dispace step by step, or you have collect one combo DVD. Within DVDs, you can get the Ubuntu, customization Goa, customization Dispace, customization Joomla, customization Drupal, everything. These DVDs you can get from the Vishwavadi. And separately, if you want to install Ubuntu and Dispace separately, then you can go to the National Digital Library, IIT Kharagpur. They are given a customization Dispace along with Ubuntu. And if you want to install the Ubuntu along with the Goa, Dispace, Joomla, and any other Drupal and any other open source software, then you can contact with our librarian, Dr. Nirmanjan Shah, and send a mail to him, and Vishwavadi provide a body video. So let's start to the installation process about Dispace in traditional process and through combo process. Now Dispace captures your queries in any format in text, video, audio, and data. It distributes it over the web. It distributes it over the web means if the book is under copyright, so you are the responsible to distribute this documents or books into the web. So you are under the Copyright Act. So before the publication of the books and documents, there is a one checkbox for terms and conditions of display or distribute your books into the web. So you are the responsible. So Copyright Act is very much important for the display. And last, after complete the metadata, when you display your documents, then one terms and conditions will become, and there is a checkbox. You have accept this terms and conditions. Otherwise, this book not be available in the web. It indexes your work so users can search and retrieve your items. It is important when you capture the document through the scanner and make a PDF file through OCR, or it may be in image format, then it has a two options. One is metadata and another is context process. If you run the OCR process, then your whole content will be searchable. And metadata would be there. Metadata also be searchable. If you have an image format, then metadata only for searching.
These are the terms that I have discussed with Google Scholar.
Hello? Next, it preserves your digital work over the long term. This provides a way to manage your research materials and publications in a professionally maintained repository to give them greater visibility and accessibility over time. So you have made a digital format your documents, means you have a safe. If the document is damaged and lost, then your document is available. This is nothing but a repository management software who can manage your digital resources, which is digitized by you, and also through metadata and also from the content. But we know that maximum documents are not run under OCR because OCR is not working on the other regional languages. Not only the regional languages, OCR is working on the English language like 80%, not 100%. So OCR covers only English language from 80%. So metadata is very much important. Here, the database within a limited field, like a qualified item is qualified Dublin code is 15. So within a 15 tag, you have to clear your details about the document. So you have a very much essential, you are very much responsible and very much reliable and very much sensible to display your documents. Preparation of the metadata is very much important. Yes, display features. Well, all of you know that display is open source software for creating digital library, collect and organize and institution intellectual production, collection, describing and disseminating digital objects. Teachers and researchers self-archive larger research expo and management support for teaching material. User full text retrieval through different search options and network options. Different search option means there is a two or three, you can browse, you can simple search, you can advanced search, you can use the advanced search. And there is the important, the teachers and researchers. They are regularly publish their research topics and their publications. They can also maintain their distress, use their publication within their distress. And all the materials are searchable within the metadata and also the document. Functions and retrieval. This is a very much important or the retrieval of the information, not the display. Powerful search engine based in between with the customizable index and full text search. Full text search means the total document is searchable if the document over under OCRC. OCR. But I have discussed with that the OCR is covered only 8% of the English language and other language is not working. So you have the essential, you have much experience and idea about the creation of metadata, harvesting of metadata. So metadata is very much important to searches, to searchable of the document. So you have mentioned the abstract, you have mentioned that keywords. So, and you can keep the image file or make a PDF file into the other location of the storage. And you have to put the link of the documents within the metadata. Send a friend and ask for a copy. Open URL support. SRW support using patch add-on module. Partition identifier over the community and collection handle starting from the 1.6 support for a other active identification such as AGR. This is the important OII PANH method. Open Archives Initiative Protocol for Metadata Harvest is a lower barrier mechanism for repository. Interoperative data providers are repositories that export structured metadata via OII PANH. You have to mention a protocol to make a metadata. Another is MES. MES is nothing but a XML file. Another is MOOCs. MOOCs is the Mark 21 format. You can also use the MOOCs metadata format for the creation of metadata catalog. And DC qualified, Dublin Core metadata. We know that there is a two options. One is qualified and another is unqualified. Qualified Dublin Core metadata has a 16 elements and unqualified metadata in Dublin Core there is a 15 elements. So we have a qualified metadata option. So there is a there are given as 16 elements. Within a 16 elements, we have to clear cut information about the document. An MPEG format, it is also XML and ISO-based, and possibility for creating customization for that. Within this format, you can use any of them. You can use MOOCs, you can use DC qualified, you can use MPA, but you have to customize about the format. Functions of metadata. Management of multiple metadata schema default DC qualified. When you install that display, automatically it works under DC, Dublin Core qualified option. If you want to use the MOOC MPG, then you can change your qualifier metadata schema. Possibility for using particular metadata schema for each collection. If you want to use one document for DC for Dublin Core metadata, another you want to use MPA, then you can use. For every document, you can customize your metadata schema. Possibility for defining the format for every metadata during the submission, name, date, restricted list, etc. UTF-8 means it is multilingual. You can use any other language. There is no variation. And multilingual metadata support. Multilingual metadata, you can use English, you can use Bengali, you can use Hindi. All over the world language you can use within this metadata system. Function is important in Alex. This is another important function for the import and export. Because you are using a display and you have made your digital resources and you have created a metadata, then you have an idea and you have an option for import. Because you import your data and send to the National Digital Library of India. Then they can export they can import their data in your institutional name. So there is so many import and export format. Import format, that is XML format, SQL, PDF, export XML, OAP image, NET, MOOC, DC qualified, NPH. So DC qualified is the best important and easy to import and export your data, metadata, and along with your documents. Then we start the installation process. You have an idea about your system requirement. You have your machine, a minimum requirement, processor, modern any. There is the i3, i5, modern. There are very much processor, active processor is available nowadays. You can use any of them. RAM minimum 2 GB, hard disk 80 GB, minimum 80 GB for display, not for your content. Because if you have a 30 or 40,000 resources, like a Vishwavati, we have near about 31,000 digital documents. It is not possible to keep all the documents within the server, within the 80 GB. So we have a separate storage. And 30,000 documents capture 7 TB data, 7 TB area of the server, storage has covered for 31,000. So it is depend on IR volume, resource repository volume, how much documents are available. And DVD drive. DVD drive is must, or also a pen drive, you can use the pen drive for installation. Internet configuration, a high-speed dedicated internet link is essential. It is also a very much essential for the internet. Without internet configuration, you can't use the Cuba and also the display. Nowadays, you have that in this lockdown period, all the institutions of the India are working on the webinar series and online classes and online documents. So in future everything will be online and everything will be digitized. So slowly but steadily we are going to the digital option, but digital resources. In future all the documents will be available in digital form. So you have a knowledge and you have a capacity about the maintenance and management and dissemination to digital option. Otherwise we are not able to lead in this society, in our profession. So you have a change your Cuba and this space or any other digital resources management software. First of all, we have this is a system. We have a first you want to install the Ubuntu and this space separately. This is the traditional process. So first, Ubuntu, before installation of the Ubuntu, last month we have seen the installation of the Cuba. Ubuntu, we know the installation of the Ubuntu. Today also we have, again, we will see the installation of the Ubuntu. Then, before installation of the Ubuntu, if you want to make a dual processing, just like Windows and Ubuntu or Linux, then you have to manage your disk. To separate the two parts, one for Windows and one for Ubuntu. You go to the right click on the computer and there is a manage. And there is a manage, after manage, there is a disk manage. If you click on the disk management, it will show more the disk position. This is a C drive boot page file, it is for Windows. And another is 97.6, this is software for D. This is 10 KFS, this is a blank question. This is a blank question, this is a empty. There is no software there any other. You can use this option, you can use this partition for the Ubuntu. Here you can click on the right click and one screen will come and there you can use the delete volume. If you click the delete volume, then it will show green symbol, that is a free space. This is a free space for any other software. IP address. After the make a free space, then you have to make the IP address. But if you are using the Windows, then you can check your IP address in the Windows. So that this IP address will be used for Ubuntu also. No other IP address is not required to make. Windows IP address will be usable for the Ubuntu also. So you have to find out the IP address from the Windows. How can you do? You can click right click on the Ethernet option, and there is a change adapter, and there is Ethernet web browser. Click on the right option and click on the properties. And there is properties, and there is the IP V4. Click on IP V4 and you can see your IP address of the Mac machine. Then after IP address, here and you define position by area of the DVD. Now the CD or pen drive through which you can boot your machine, then start with the installation process. There is a fast installation. Image will become this type. You can move to the install Ubuntu. Click on the install Ubuntu, then it will come on the next step. There are two options. You have to follow the screen. There is a green symbol for the two and another for the install the third party software. If you want to make your dual processor, Windows, and you can use your free space for the Ubuntu, then you click on the installation of this third party software and click on the continue. And there is a two options. Here's this installation Ubuntu. If you use this, erase this installation, it will erase total this along with the Windows also. So you don't use this option. You go to the something else for the dual processing. You have to use the something else for dual processing. Here you will get that option for the free space. You click on the free space and change the total free space is 8589 8 GB, but you have to make for home drive, home directory and root directory and any other directory for this maintain or manage the display software and your IR in the repository process. So you have to click the change option. Here total space will be shown. Here you can use make the clear. Here you can use the mount point. You can use the this symbol for root. You can use the for home option. You can use boot option, and you can make this size. Here that when you use the flat option for root, and here you can use the 3000, like a 3 GB, and another 5 GB you can make for home for 2 GB and boot for 3 GB. So you can manage your disk properly to make your display and OVA along with your distribution repository. There is no need for the swap because nowadays RAM is very much high. Minimum 2 GB and 4 GB RAM are coming from there with the new hardware. So you don't need to make a swap. Swap is traditional for the fast searching and management of the distro repository database. Institutional prerequisite authentication. After the disk management, for the disk space, how this software is very much important for the disk. Otherwise, you can't use the disk. Java development is JDK, latest version. PostgreSQL database, PostgreSQL database, not MariaDB or MySQL. MariaDB, MySQL for Koa, but PostgreSQL database for disk. Disk software Apache and Duo Java Build tool, Apache Maven, Apache Build automation tool for Java project. It is totally under the Java language. So every software which supports the Java and Java tool, it's required for the distribution. And Apache Tomcat, web serial service for the hosting system. Apache Tomcat, there for this Apache Tomcat is essential, and to our Apache, only Apache is important. So before click on this Windows option, this option, then you can install your Ubuntu automatically. Then you have to install the distro. This software, there are six software is essential for the distro. Installation of distro. Open application accessories terminal and execute the following command. Apply following. This is a traditional process. You have to install this distro step by step. First, you have to run your terminal option. In Ubuntu, after installation of the Ubuntu, here Ubuntu is a blank Ubuntu. Any other software and application is not available in Ubuntu. So you have to update your Ubuntu properly and update the, for the latest version of the Ubuntu. So ACDU update, this update option for Ubuntu. When you run this command, automatically update your Ubuntu properly. And sudo apt update. Upgrade means it is a upgradation of the Ubuntu. If you are using 14.03, it will go to the 16.05 or anything. Then, after installation, we have to install the six software separately. If you do apt install libstat. Libstat is one editor for the software for Ubuntu. Also Gedit also, there is another editor. So you have to check that Libstat is available in your Ubuntu or not. If it is not available, then you can install Libstat. Only comments, you do apt install Libstat. Automatically it will install a Libstat. But we want to install the Java and Maven. You do apt install Libstat, open JDK, 8 JDK and Maven. Yes. Java and Maven automatically installed separately one by one. And it will take long time, minimum 30 to 40 minutes time to taken for Maven. Then you go to the Postgres.org community for installation of the Postgres. This is the 9.6. Or if you go to the Postgres.org, then there is a latest version is available. If you don't know the latest version of the Postgres, you go use this command, Postgres.org pub report. It will go to the Postgres and we get quite low. It is a Postgres media keys. Keys means it will go to the latest version of the Postgres. Then you can install the Postgres automatically. If you have to get update, this update automatically Ubuntu will update and Postgres also will update. If you have to install Postgres 9.6. After Postgres installation, you have to create the database for this, for metadata along with the visualization. This configuration is very much essential for creation of the database. We have seen in the Koha, there is a option for customization of the and create the databases in MySQL. So another option is available in the distro. Here we have to create the database for the distro. Sudo su postgres. Here, create your username. You can use your field username. No super user from databases. Enter password new row. Enter password example distro. You can use any other password for the data that. It is depend upon you. The select the new role after enter your password, this command will come. Tell the new role they allow to create more one role, yes or no. You have to clear no. Enter the press enter button and create the database and Unicode. This is very much important. Unicode button. Then you can use the multilingual option. Otherwise, you can't. Then create the extension, PostgreSQL and SQL. This is the this command is only for creation of the database and user for PostgreSQL database. After installation of the PostgreSQL database, you open the PostgreSQL configuration file in libstack and add this line local all distance in the file. Local all distance in the file. You copy this option and paste on the last line. Add this line to the configuration file at the end. There is so many configuration is written in the PostgreSQL configuration file. You paste this line on the last line and save and close the file and restart the PostgreSQL. How to restart the PostgreSQL? Simply you can see in a zip PostgreSQL dot restart. Automatically PostgreSQL will restart. Create the distance window. After PostgreSQL installation and customization of the PostgreSQL and customization of the PostgreSQL configure file, then you have to create the displays user. QT user and displays, enter password for the new user displays, QT make DI. Make DI displays. Displays is the first directory. Under this folder, you have to make another folder for home and fire. Any folder will become under the display. So displays is the first folder. Pseudo con displays display means displays has given the full permission, read, write, and execute. And you go to the displays of folder and pseudo netdir build pseudo con build and make a build file under the display. First you create a folder and make a another folder build under the display and give the full permission in build folder also. This is command for sudo chmod r777 means execute, write and read. Full 777 means execute, write and read. Full permission for the build folder. And download the display into the build directory. And download the display software on the go to the display watching community and you have to download the display total display software in the build folder and we get the issue. You can find the latest update and display 5.8, 5.10, 5.11, 5.12, any other version you can get from this page and copy the link to download latest version. And there is a link given for every version. 5.8 means 5.10 is another link, 5.11 is another link. If you want to latest version of the display, then you copy the latest version link and paste on the terminal. It will automatically download the display latest version in your build directory. After installation the build directory of the display, it will come in the tar file. This is a big file, so it will not come in a big size, so it will come under the tar file. So you have to enter the display folder into the build file. This is the command tar tar build display. This is come. And release the simple engine item to package. Enter into display and automatically display will enter your build type. And go to the CD display target display installer pseudo and press dot installer. You have to install the ANT. You have to figure you have download the NVM, you have download the ANT. Now it will be installed separately. Just download first. So all the six software and install after step by step. CTOPT and download that Tomcat also. And under this Tomcat, we have some customization. Sudo NVM Apache Tomcat, delete the Tomcat packet file from the OPT folder. After the installation the Tomcat and install the Tomcat, we delete the Tomcat packet from the OPT folder. And that run the remove the Apache Tomcat .tar.jv. All the files come under the tar file. After installation the Tomcat, you have to remove the Apache Tomcat. Open the file. Again, see the profile. Again, you have to Tomcat configuration file to zip file editor. Set up environmental variables. It is also very important for the environment variable. Means it's total depending on the Java language. So you have a Java home and Java path. You have to declare or show the Tomcat. Here the Java home is available and here Java application is available. So you have to mention the Java path. Export the Java user lib Java 8 OpenJDK NVP4. Export this and copy this web app file Tomcat and web app OPT Tomcat web app. This is the path. And here the distress file is available. Running the Tomcat automatically, you can set the start, the Tomcat server start automatically at the time, system time. Sudo libg after this installation and mention the data of the Java, mention the web page of the web page, web apps of the distress, then you have to open the int.d of Tomcat. Here, you have to copy this command. This is the total command. You have to copy this command and paste under the Tomcat. Add all in lines in the Tomcat. Copy this version in search by requirements and path is been in the bin. Where is the Java is available? Where is the Tomcat is available? Where is the ANT is available? Where is the NVM available? Where is the PostgreSQL available? This total path will be shown in the Tomcat INT file. Next, update the Tomcat and start the Tomcat file. SUDO service Tomcat file, then Tomcat will be started. Now you can start and stop the Tomcat server using the following command. You can stop the Tomcat start and Tomcat stop. This is the common command. And you can run the service of the Tomcat, total service of the Tomcat. Apply the following in the terminal. SUDO will distress create administrator. Now distress is installed. PostgreSQL is installed, PostgreSQL database is created, distance database and user is created, Tomcat is created, all the path is going in the Tomcat. Now we have to make for distance administrator through which you can create the metadata, you can upload your database, you can upload your distance repositories. And you can customize your distress folder. You can customize your distress design also. So you have to create a distress administrator. Enter the email address, distress@drupal.org, and enter the first name of the subnet, like example distress. Enter a password. You have to create your password your own, or you can change your password in future. After the creation of the administrator, you delete the build file. Build file created under the digital folder, because all the digital file and compact file are downloaded in the disk build. It will take the space, so you have to delete or the folder. You can delete through mouse also, or you can use this command CTRL underscore RF plus build. It will automatically delete the build. Now this page is ready. Here two files will be open for this page. One for HTML one, one for JSP one. You can use anyone, no one. If you want to customize HTML, then you can customize your HTML, or you can use the JSPY, then you can customize your JSP. You have to mention that which file you are customizing. Then you can use this option. And localhost means you can use the localhost or you can use your IP, which is available in Windows if you are using a dual processor. And there is a 8080 port. It is a very important. In last month, we have told you that you don't use this port 8080 for any purpose for COBA. You can use 700, 800. 500, 600, 900, any port you can use, only except 8080, because 8080 port is only for defined for Tomcat all over the world. So don't use the 8080 port with the UHA or any other browser, because 8080 for Tomcat. If you mention this port any other, then it will not run the display properly. And contact will come problem. This is the traditional process, and so many command is available, so many customization is required, so many installation, so many downloaded process is important for installation of this. After this installation, you have the knowledge of the customization. But this is a traditional process. If you contact with the Vishwabharati, or if you want to customize in this space, if you want to customize it, you don't want to customize or for installation this typical process, then you go to the NVLI site. There is the Ubuntu along with the disk space is available. You can download and install in your machine. Then Ubuntu and disk space will be automatically available in your machine. But there is only this case. But in this world, we have a promo DVD. With this DVD, you can get Ubuntu, Koha, Distel, Joomla, Drupal, or any other open source software, OpenOffice, any other open source. No need to customize any of the critical process. So again, we see how to install the process on the DVD. It is very much easy and comfortable. First, you enter the DVD in the machine and run from the input to the BIOS option and boot first from the DVD. Then DVD will run. Click on the Dell to run setup, and automatically live DVD will come. There is a two options: one live system and installation. If you want to use this live system, you can also use this live system. Means it will not install in your machine. It will work under DVD. You can use this DVD, but it is not for the display, because before display, you have to upload your document. So there is a no space in the DVD. So you have to install the DVD in your machine. You click on the install, start the installation directly. One step by step, one, you have to clear first of the which language you want to use. This is DVD. Here also, again, in the begin we have seen there is a two options. This is as the last I did available in the drive there, I is connected to the internet. Two options. So first, you have to manage your DVD disk partition for the Ubuntu if you want to do processing, or if you want to make a single server, then you can erase your DVD or you can erase your total option in the disk and show that and internet connection and click on the continue. There also there is the option installation for erase Ubuntu. If you have a Windows, close that erase Windows. Don't use this. If you want to do the system, go to the something else and use your free space according to your management. And you go to the India option, there is a Kolkata. Next, keyboard language, English, you continue. And your name. Your name means your name and your computer's name, your nickname, your password. If you want to make a password, you have to clear the password. Anything according to your requirement. Then install the process is processed. Install it will take near about half an hour. Total option is taken 40 to 45 minutes. And installation popping files. It copies the file from the DVD into the RAM, then install the file and then restart the option. You click on the restart, that DVD will come automatically. You pick out the DVD from the DVD drive and close the DVD drive and click on the restart. Now your Ubuntu, Suha, Drupal, Joomla, Dispatch, everything installed within this process. No need to customize, no need to download, no need to installation process, no need to creation of that Postgres database. Everything is created and customized with this computer. So only install this Ubuntu, automatically all the software will be available in your network. Now we will see the minimum customization and using the metadata and uploading the document to Dispatch. This is the Dispatch option. This is a header file. You can customize and change this header. You can change this logo. You can use this logo in your institution. You can make your institutional name. And this is the navigation bar. You can change this navigation bar, and this is the Dispatch My Community location bar. You can change your name, you can use your name in the institution, and this is the footer. Total design, color, everything you can design to the style dot file. You can change this, you go to the Dispatch, you go to the contact, you go to the weather, there is a two options, JSPY and XML UI. If you want using the XML UI, you go to the XML UI and there is a style.jpg. You can change this option properly. Or if you are using the JSPY, then you go to the Dispatch and change this style.jpg. The total design is complete. Now, created the metadata. Before this creation of the database, you have to create the community. First, you have to create the community. You go to the community and collect it from the browser panel. And first of all, you have to log in. There is a login option. After login, this option will come. Otherwise, only search option will come. A login option, you have made the user ID and your password. Then use this administrative user ID and password, automatically all the functions will come. And there is a select community. Select the create top level community from the admin function. You have to community, create the community according to your institution name. Just like we have created this also, library network digital library. Or you have a XXX college library digital library. This is the first community. After, in this community, you clear the mention, address, email address of your institution, and complete the metadata for the community, and click create to complete the community. First, you have to create the main community. Under this, there is a two sub community. There is a two sub community you can create. One for e-books, for digitized books. One for question paper. Another for faculty or research scholar presentation. There you can create another three sub community for paper purposes. If you want to create a digital book, you have to create the digital community. You have to create the question paper. You have to create the question paper for the sub community. You have to create the faculty publication. You have to create the faculty publication community. Under this question paper, you have to create another option, collection. Means collection is the important. Under this collection, you have to create the metadata. So collection, create the collection administrator, and under this question paper, you have to make the collection under 2019, 2020, 2021, the like this. And under this collection, you have to create the metadata of the question paper along with the link. Or if it is available in PDF, means OCR, then you can upload your data. Let's get the description metadata for the collection and select the user who can submit the collection and the name. Another, when you create the collection, that you have the mention, the user who can only upload or create the metadata for this. Everybody can do this. According to your administrative position, he can or they can do this one. So it is also important for creation of the digital library. And you can have an idea who is upload this digital book, who is upload this question paper, who upload this faculty publication. If there is any problem, then you can ask them. After this collection, when you create a new collection, there are these 16 elements will come. Under this 15 BC W4 qualified items, you have to create the metadata. This is the metadata. It is another part, metadata addressing. It is another part, and another time is required for discussion of the all the tag and files. So how to manage the digital resources within these 15 elements. But in Kuha, there is a 9000 or 900 and 999 option from 000. There is so many tabs to describe the physical document. But in digital document, there is no option, only 16 elements. Within the 16 elements, you have to clear cut description of the document. If the document is not available in the OCR format, if you're using only the link, then metadata is very much important for search the document. Otherwise, if the document is available and your metadata is not good, then the document will not be. So this is the title. Title here in book format, know the title. Creator, please create the option. You can also create the author, subject, description, publisher, contributor, date. This is the very three mandatory things: title, creator, and date. This is three important mandatory field to create the data. So title, create, subject, description, publisher, contributor. In question, title, this is a department. Creator, organization, means this or any other. Subject, which subject we have to question paper. Publisher is the organization. Contributor is nothing. Date, which year. This question we have belongs to which year. Type means this is the books, other ways, any other pamphlet, public article. This is the type. Format, which format, PDF, any other format. Identifier, source, course, we have used the URL. You have to use the URL for the document if it is not available in OCR format, like a PDF and searchable format. If you are using only the link and your resource is available in another place, then you have to use this link for the resource. Language, which language documents are available? Relation, coverage, and rights. Rights is copyright, access is important. After this, when you create this metadata and upload this document, there before publication of your document, one terms and condition will come. This is very much important and you have to check for Copyright Act how much documents, how much page will be available in digital format or how much page will be downloadable and how much page is copy, how much page is printable. It should be maintained properly. When you create the PDF and make this restriction for downloading the document. Otherwise, you will be under copyright. This is very much essential for you have to study the Copyright Act or terms and conditions of the PDF before the publication. There is a checkpoint, checkbox, after complete the metadata or upload the document and using the link, then you have to click on the checkbox under the terms and condition, then it will be published. Otherwise, this place will not allow to publish your publication without acceptance of terms and condition of the Copyright Act. The Copyright Act and this place, it is another topic. It is another topic. It is very much interesting topic. How much place, how it is managed without copyright violation. Because now they are giving that so many classes are available in the online, so many documents available in the MOOCs. So if you want to upload your new document, it will be available under the copyright. So how it will overcome this question? How it will solve this problem? How this is an important book. This is very much important book. It is very much important for uploading the display for the user. So how it will manage? Then when you use your OCR and make your PDF, then there should be a restriction of it. That to restrict the document to download. If you want to give permission for 10 pages or 3 pages or any other pages for printout and download, then you can give the permission. So, Copyright Act in this case is very much interesting part. Metadata creation and uploading the document, it is another part, and terms and condition of the information. This case, it is very much important. So you have to be careful and you download the display, you collect the combo box, combo DVD from Visuality, or you can download the display from NDLI and use this option. Because Suha and display, everything is needs self-study. Self-study is the best for development this opportunity. So you have a knowledge and you have a capacity. So you are requested to download the Quora display and use this. And when you are using this, it will give some problem. It will solve the new things. So you can ask anybody. There are so many scholars and so many persons available to help you. So all of you are requested to download this software, which are available in the world. So use this properly. When you have problem, you ask anybody, not me, anybody. There are so many persons available. Or you can ask me also. So we are always ready to help you. So self-study is the best study for development. One lecture and see the presentation, it is not sufficient for development of the business and Java or anything. So you have to download and use. Thank you very much. This is my simple experience about Java and business. So I share it if it is helpful. Thank you, Papasda. Hello, anybody question is there, then I can
explain. Hello, Ramprasad. Hello. Hello, Ramprasad.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Nimai Chan Saha. Hello.
Hello.
Ramprasad. I'm Nimai Chan Saha.
Yes,
see, actually, I have one question to you.
Yes.
I have one question to you on behalf of the all participants.
Yes.
And I think you are the right person who can clarify and answer the questions. Let's say that I am not the part and parcel of Vishwa Bharati Library Network.
Yes.
See, I am a librarian of a school, college, and I have some interest on researching this Koha, then your DSpace and Profind by integrating this Ubuntu and other things. Okay.
Yes.
So my question to you, what do they expect any cooperation from Vishwa Bharati Library Network like Fellow you and other team members from Vishwa Bharati Library Network? Do they expect any cooperation without any point? Please answer the question.
Yes. Manda, it is a great opportunity to ask. So all the software is available in the web freely. So why we can take the price? To something develop the customization or something save the design. So if the total software is available freely, so how can I accept for money? So it is available in the Vishwabhati. You all are requested to send the mail to our librarian without the institutional permission. Without institutional permission, like a librarian permission, we can't produce the software and supply the products. So because all the developers are in the institution.
Is there any
Hello?
Support from you?
Yes. If there is any problem. Yes, always ready. Yeah, in first place, I have given the
contact number.
So okay, on behalf of Ramprasad, hello, myself Dr. Nimai Chan Saha, on behalf of Ramprasad and on behalf of the Vishwa Bharati Library Network and on behalf of the Vishwa Bharati Library Authority, let me give you one message to all participants that we will be kind enough to extend any support free of cost as Ramprasad rightly mentioned. You can send any queries, any questions to our library team members through mail, particularly to Ramprasad and others. Okay. And our contact number or mail ID is available in the library web portal. No need to ask here to contact number and mail ID. Right today, I don't think it's a problem of not having contact number and not having this kind of mail ID. In our library portal, everything is there, personal mobile number and mail ID. So please contact with us to enlight your institution, to enlight your personal competency. Okay. So thank you. Please take care.
Thank you, Nimaida, for your joining here and for your valuable suggestions and information for all participants. Now, if you have any question to the participant from the participant, then you can write down the chat box and also to send the mail to us. Then we can give the answer to you. Or another request to all of you that to mute the all audio except one to raise the question only. He will be unmute the microphone only. Otherwise, all participants should keep the mute their microphone. Please, if you have any question. Okay, now we are going to Okay, now we are going to participation. So please open your video right now to take a session photo. All participants are requested to open our video right now. We will take a session video, and Ramprasad also requests you to stay on the video.
Okay. Thank you, Ramprasad.
Okay. Next, another photo. All are not opening their video. I am seeing that. Most of the participants are not opening the video. Please open. Please share the video right now. Saptoshi sir. Good morning, sir. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. We are let me finish the program. Okay. Thank you. Tomorrow we will see again. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hello. Hello. Hello, Amin. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yes.